Okay, so we have a brand new game. I don't know if they're gonna go straight into it or if this is a button check. But once again, this is looking kind of serious. So I'm gonna assume that they're going straight into it. A button check state is usually Midgar. This isn't Midgar, so this has to be serious. So Tosaka in the lead, doing a good job at snuffing out Yoshi's usual hit and run gameplay. Being a bit bold with his approaches and very responsive and reactive as well to Narco's options. We just see Tosaka playing a very solid neutral right now. Narco seems to be having a bit of a hard time just getting in, actually. And that's the first stock with just a clean 22% on Tosaka. Looking really, you know, looking real sharp right now. And Yoshi's throwing a bit of confetti. Give me a second. Sorry, I had to mute my mic for a second. Okay, so Narco seems to be doing a bit of a good job catching up, and well, Tosaka made up for a bit of the deficit, but he still has a whole stock to get off of Tosaka. So let's see how he's able to close this one out. Tosaka once again has Narco at ledge. He managed to make it back, and that's not quite gonna do it just yet. Neither is that. I think that's some good DI coming out from Tosaka, actually. And that's the kill confirmed. That's gonna do it. So Tosaka has 60% extra credit. That's not too good, not too bad. It's definitely something that Narco can make up for. But once again, you can see that Tosaka is doing a very good job at just snuffing out these little loops in Yoshi's gameplay. And that's gonna be the checkmate. So first game goes to Tosaka, getting it with the checkmate.
Oh, winner is...
I got you.
All in. Survival.
I need to update the scores. Okay, so they're going straight into it. See no switches coming out from either characters. They're going to the same stage as well. Both of them just playing the neutral out. That was kind of sneaky. Okay, that actually killed. That was disgusting, actually. I'm not gonna lie. Well, I don't think anybody was expecting that, except maybe Narco himself. But Narco getting an early stock on Tosaka. Let's see what happens. Woo! Okay, I imagine Sosaka wants to close out this talk as soon as possible. Just even up this game a little bit. Trying to take advantage of Yoshi off stage, but he's getting a little anxious. These options. But you find that in situations like these, Sosaka's a very just-doing kind of guy. But Narco's gonna enjoy the little lead that he has, just take it cool for a few eggs. And not approach if he doesn't have to. Yeah, just extend his advantage where he can, but we can see that he's not being too committal. And we have a double KO, but Yoshi was up as fuck, so that game goes to Narco. Sorry if I can't update it, I seem to be having some technical difficulties. And we finally see a switch coming out from Narco. He's gonna go to his Mario. A very symbolic character for Narco. What most people know him for, actually. Not too sure what brought the switch on, but he most likely has a plan or a reason in mind. After all, this is a best of five, so he does have a few games to play around. And if he manages to win this, we'll go into true grand finals, making it another best of five. But as it stands currently, we're at one all for each character. Yeah, both characters just beating each other out as usual, just playing the neutral. And we have some ledge traps coming up from Sosaka. And he gets a kill off of it. Or maybe I spoke too soon. But he's keeping him in the disadvantage. Manages to find his way back to stage, but quickly thrown back off by Sosaka. And almost saved, but well, I guess no one was expecting. No one was expecting that. Alright, so we have a very hype game going on. So it's back to even, both players with one stock. I mean, Sosaka has no advantage anymore. It's looking like Mario's trying to run away with this. But one Mario combo usually brings you about this percent, so I dare say it's kind of even. Going out on the fairs. That up air, not quite gonna do it yet. I imagine around now Sosaka's probably gonna play a bit more patient, try to rack up the damage where he can, make this game look a bit more even. That's actually the kind of guy Sosaka is. He's still playing very well, managing to avoid the... Wowee. Well, I guess that's what they call commentator's curse. So that is 2-1 in the favor of Narco. Again, I'm sorry I can't update these scores. I'm having some technical difficulties on my side. And they're going back into the next game. We see Town and City again with the Mario pick again. And it's kind of important to note how both characters kind of benefit from this stage. Robin, of course, gets the checkmate to kill a couple percents earlier. It's... My God. Wow. Okay, so that's some good DI coming out from Sosaka. But this is the advantage that I was talking about for Mario, or I wanted to get into. Mario has these up air strings into his up B that could lead to very early death. I know Kel calls this the Stairway to Heaven. But Robin does gain some advantage from the platforms as well. At some point, this stage turns into Battlefield, and Robin does benefit from the triplats. Missed ledge trap by Tosaka. Mario skips combo, but Tosaka takes advantage with his Nosferatu. This game is still looking fairly even. That's still not gonna kill quite yet. Tosaka needs to get up from the ledge here. Makes his way back to the stage. That's some good awareness from Narco, being able to keep the book like that. The book is so small, a lot of people aren't able to see it. And that's a quick mix-up from Tosaka there. Going for the gales instead of the fire on those jabs. Who chases him down for the up smash, so let's get it. Both characters looking at kill percent right now. Tosaka looking in a bit of a sticky situation. Going for some hard reads on these characters there. Yeah, Narco really going in. Showing just his knowledge of the character, showing his knowledge of the matchup and the player. He's really weaving himself in and out of Tosaka's range, just barely managing to avoid death. Tosaka with the amazing tech, but he rolls into the up smash. And Narco's gonna be up a stock. Let's see if Tosaka can make a comeback from this. See some Mario combos coming out. Oh, this is some savagery right here, actually. Not quite gonna get the spike on that. Or the edge guard that he wanted. And that's gonna take it, the gentleman from Robin. But he's still at this deficit. Mario has an 83% extra credit, and it just keeps going up. Let's see if Tosaka can do anything about this. I imagine right now, like you've seen, Mario probably wants to fish for these up smashes. And that's gonna take it. So that is a bracket reset, ladies and gentlemen. Bracket reset, both players going back into it, going into Smashville. So no switches coming from Tosaka right now. And back to the same old story. Yoshi throws some eggs, Tosaka throws some lightning. Once again, he's doing a good job at keeping Yoshi out. Really preventing his hit and run gameplay. And Tosaka taking quite a considerable lead right now. One more misstep might lead to a checkmate. And we can see that Tosaka's looking for it. Narco has actually been doing a good job at managing to stay alive and avoid getting grabbed. So I have to admit that the only thing Robin can really grab with that animation of his is like a cold or something. But he has taken his first hit for the last couple of seconds. And he... that's some great DI coming out from Narco, actually. So this is a bit of the hard part where both characters kind of struggle to kill each other. Both of them are out of combo range. And Narco is being very tenacious with his survivability. But that will take it. So Sokka's sitting comfortably at 73% right now. He's off stage. Let's see if we can get an edge guard situation. Narco doing a good job at keeping him off. And we have reset back to neutral. Oh, going for the shield break here. And that's going to be the stop. Okay, so Sokka only having 38% extra credit. This is looking very even for both characters. One Yoshi combo should be able to bring this back dead even. Sokka looking to cheese a kill with the Smash Bros. Platforms and Blast Zones. So we're gonna be seeing a lot of egg throwing, lightning throwing for the next couple of seconds. Both players just barely weaving in and out of each other's effective range. So Sokka gets a fairly decent lead at this point. It's kind of looking like both guys are at 2%, to be honest. That could have been it. Ah, and that's a kill confirm. That's gonna take it. Okay, so Narco is up one. So it's 1-0 for true grand finals. Yoshi. Okay, and we see the switch coming out from Narco, so he has gone back to Mario. No switches coming from Sokka right now. I imagine Sokka kind of wants to do this entire thing with Robin. Maybe not feeling too confident in his Mario Lucina right now. Mario chases him down. And just, really being in Sokka's face, he just barely misses the down B spike. And there it is, he gets the footstool. There's no way that wasn't intentional. And there he is. Will he do it? Okay, that doesn't take it just yet. But that was some crazy stuff coming out from Sokka. But of course, this isn't anything that Mario can't come back from. Okay, excellent patience from Rick, knowing and having the awareness to just shield through the entire thing. But I imagine he wants the kill right now and he finds it. Okay, so Tosaka is one Mario combo away from making this even. He goes for the B recovery. Trying to keep Mario off the stage, going for an Edgeguard situation. Rick has the awareness to escape it. And this might be a bit of a struggle. Excellent recoveries by Tosaka. He mixes it up every time. A real awareness of his character and his capabilities. Tosaka right now doing a good job of just keeping Mario out. But I imagine both characters are looking for the kill right now. What, not quite yet. Oh, just barely avoiding death, Tosaka did. Tosaka's just gonna comfortably camp the platform for the time being. Slowly baiting for that back throw. And the up air is gonna take it, a very powerful move by Robin. And that makes it 1-1 for True Grand Finals. Again, I apologize that I couldn't update the scoreboard. I think Tosaka is going to be very angry with me for this afterwards. But hey, you got to work with what you get. I'm sorry I can't bring any more excitement than this to the videos, but it's been a very long day. We've switched from venues, everyone's tired. But I want to give some shout outs to the players for toughing it out, for lasting this long. I know Tosaka especially had a hard day, he was TOing as well. But he's still playing well, still playing out of his mind. And shoutouts to Rick as well, who of course is a very excellent player, very known in the Caribbean, very known in this region. And I want to give a big thank you to him and the other Bajans for making it out here and showing up and you know, overall supporting the stream, supporting Big Bang, and supporting the scene and the community. Alright, so back to the game. Things are looking kind of even. Tosaka has an edgeguard situation here, but Mario makes it back to stage. Both players looking to get a few hits in. Mario looking for some opening for Robin's projectile game here. He misses the spike on the fair. Not too big a problem. Tosaka manages to make it back to stage. Now, I mentioned this before when they fought, but Mario... Whoa, that's a really good Nosferatu. Mario really does like and appreciate this stage because it allows him to extend his up air combos. It leads to big damage and a lot of time potential kills. And Robin also appreciates Triplat because she can block off a lot of the stage with her arc fire. Additionally, it allows her to extend a few up air strings. You don't see it too often, but it can happen. But it's a matter of who benefits more from the stage. I dare say Mario does for greater benefit on this stage. But Tosaka seems to be doing fairly well. Mario does, of course, have the advantage, but both characters are at kill percent. And it's never over until it's over. And that stock's over. Of course, with Robin sitting at 120, even though this is Battlefield, it should be very possible for Mario to close off this kill. So let's see what Narco does with his options. Excellent patience from Narco, but also excellent awareness from Tosaka. And that is excellent awareness from Narco to reflect that item. And this is why we turn items off, guys. Thank you. That was actually really impressive from Nago. I'm still thinking about that. But we're on to the next stock. Tosaka doesn't have too much extra credit. Again, one Mario combo is probably going to put him in the lead here. But Tosaka doing a fairly decent job at keeping him out. Ooh, that was quite it. And here it is, the Mario combo. Both characters just resetting to neutral. Narco looking for Tosaka to give him an opening. That might be the opening he needs. This game once again is looking kinda even. Just to keep him off stage. Not quite getting the spike on that hit. I imagine both players are looking to close off the stock right now. And it's actually looking kind of tense between them. They're both playing incredibly safe. The back throw isn't going to take it just yet, but it will put Tosaka in disadvantage. Marco missing his edge guard opportunity. Gentleman will take it from that side of the stage. And that's a fake out. Tosaka gonna get it with the back air. So that is 1-2 in Tosaka's favor. Again, I have to repeat 1-2 in Tosaka's favor because this wasn't, it's not being reflected on the scoreboard. We're getting one more shout for Tosaka. Okay, so no changes. Are we possibly? Nope, no changes. So we're going back to the same stage, the same characters. Tosaka at tournament point, and Narco needing two games to take this home. So the pressure is on for both these players. I mean, a lot is on the line. Both of them representing their countries, representing where they came from. And Tosaka having a lot of support being from the whole field. You see some Mario combos coming out. Not able to extend them. Ooh, Tosaka not having the awareness of his spells. But here he goes. Nako in an edge guard situation. Oh, that's not quite gonna do it. Okay, Nako finally makes it back to stage. Keep it neutral. Some very nasty stuff coming out from Tosaka. Nako needing just a moment to gather himself after that. But I really hope this doesn't really deter him. Nako, again, a great player. And he's been in worse situations. He can come back from this. I gotta say though, even with that very early stock, Nako is keeping to a cool and calm, collected kind of gameplay. A lot of people would rush in after that and try to close out a stock as easy as possible, quickly as possible. But he has a game plan and he's sticking to it. That could have been it, actually. Tosaka's still racking on the extra credit right now. Nako seems to be having a hard time just securing that kill for the time being. And that's gonna take it. Alright, so Narco sitting at 57. Again, not too bad, not too much of a deficit. Well, he's at 17 now. Again, the one Mario combo on Battlefield. But Tosaka doesn't give a hoot, he's just going in. And both players just not doing much of anything, waiting for the other to take the first action. But Tosaka is really feeling himself. He's playing... I know you guys don't see it, but he's actually playing a little more aggressive than usual. Okay. And we're gonna see a... That's not gonna take it quite yet. Battlefield, of course, having these enlarged blast zones. Some good DI coming out from Narco. Tosaka playing a bit risky here. Seems like he might be anxious to close this off. Yeah, it's been a long day. I'm sure we're all tired. I'm sure he wants to go home too. Probably just wants to end this and go home. No Mario combos coming off of this. His rage might be a little high. Alright, and Narco makes a comeback from that. So, both players are at tournament point. And I imagine the pressure must be very, very intense for both of these players. Taking some time at this character select screen. And as expected, they're gonna go back to it. And we might see Smash now? I'm thinking either Smashville or Town and City, because this is Tosaka's pick. Alright, so we're going on to Smashville. The last game of Big Bang set is going to happen at Smashville. Mario and Robin. Now, a really important thing to note is that Mario no longer has these platforms to really take advantage of. So this might give Tosaka an easier time. But another important thing to note is that these backstrokes from Mario are gonna kill more reliably on this stage, as well as Mario's down smash, forward smash, etc. So let's see how well they're able to make use of this stage. Good awareness from Tosaka, knowing what is and isn't a frame trap. We're seeing a more intense game than the last couple of games, in my opinion. Both characters kind of slung at each other. Robin had a bit of plot armor right there. Okay, Tosaka having the awareness to check that time. And Narco with the patience to just stay in shield. And Narco looking to close this off as quickly as possible, it seems. Never missing the opportunity when it strikes, I guess. Tosaka makes it back to stage. Narco still maintains control of the stage, but just zipping in and out of Tosaka's area. And nothing comes off of that. Ooh, Narco gets the up smash, so Narco here needs one more stock to take this home. And Tosaka got the checkmate. Alright, so we're looking at a very even game. Both characters back on one stock off both players. Needing only to take one stock to take this home, to take the game, to take Big Bang. And things are looking kinda intense for both these players right now. Yahoo! I know this victory means a lot to both of these guys. They've had a lot of tournament history. And I know both of them want specifically this win over the other. So I imagine it's gonna come down to who wants this win the most. Okay, not too much happening right now as expected. Both players playing very cautiously. As you'd expect when so much is on the line for just one stock. But Tosaka playing a very hit and run game. Just letting it be known that he does have the advantage right here. A very risky move from Narco, not sure what he was going for there. Missing the pivot grab, and Narco hounds him down. Okay, getting some good damage onto Tosaka. Keeping him off the stage. Tell that both of these players really want it. And that's gonna take it. Yeah, you're gonna see the screams and the shouts. This is where I get off of commentary. Tosaka takes it. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. I get to go home. And I have some shit talking to do. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Big Bang. Thank you very much for sticking with us.